I am Dr. Levent Çelik from Istanbul, Turkey. I am breast radiologist. I want to share my experience about how I use AI in breast mammography and tomosynthesis. First of all, I have to explain my situation. It's a private setting, not a part of the national screening program. I mostly make opportunistic screening. Approximately 50% of my cases is opportunistic breast cancer screening. I do 25% diagnostic exam and approximately 25% is also follow-up of the breast cancer cases. Also, in our situation, we make simultaneous sonography in the same room. We perform online reporting after the mammography and sonography. We prepare instant report, and we use two different AI systems simultaneously as a decision support system in our setting. Today in this workshop, I would like to share my experience with AI in mammography and tomosynthesis. I have using one of them approximately for 6 years. This is the Transpara. Also, I use Lunit for approximately 3 years. This is my examination room. Technicians perform the mammography, then take the lady to do sonography in the same room. In the same room, we have PACS and AI workstations. We can see the previous ultrasound exam at the back of the sonography bed. Also, we can see the AI results at the back of the screen. We can use AI to guide all our ultrasound to the suspicious areas. We have same setting in the second room. We have two same setting mammography and sonography rooms. All in our, this is my reporting room. We use Transpara on the right hand side. This is the Lunit on the left hand side. After we write the report, I briefly talk each patient face to face to inform them about their report. This is the middle screen. This is the left hand side is the current exam. Right hand side is the usually previous exam. Okay. First, I want to explain the user interface of these systems with a basic case. This is the 56 years old lady. Can you open case number zero? It's not sequential in your workstations. Okay. AJ will help assist me during this workshop. You can see the explanation of the lady. And Transpara system sent an capture image with a risk stratification. There is elevated risk, intermediate risk, and low risk. It is their stratification system, and it highlights the suspicious area by square and written a score close to the area suspicious score. This is the tomo. If there is available tomo on the left hand side of the transparent screen is the 2D evaluation. Right hand side is the tomo evaluation. This is the tomo results. And Transpara also sent a structural report to our PACS system. With this structural report, our PACS vendor integrate Transpara into our PACS system. You can use Transpara interactively via our PACS without the need for screen capture image. You can click on the button. You can see the suspicious area on the 2D images as highlighted areas. Also, you can see the Transpara shows the tomo results on the synthetic mammograms. This is the screen capture from our PACS station. when you click on the suspicious area, system directly jumps on the related tomo image. Transpara does not evaluate separately synthetic mammograms, but marks the synthetic mammogram via tomosynthesis data. This is the Lunit screen. Lunit does not send a structural report and it's not integrated our PAC system. Lunit screen capture image suspicious area as a heat map or risk zones, depends on your preference. Lunit also evaluates synthetic mammograms as a separate sequence of mammograms and evaluate them separately. Lunit also has a tomo version, but it's not working properly in our system because they don't train their system, they say, with Fuji images. Also, this is the case of the sonography in your workstation. We have related sonography, MRI or PET images of the cases. Okay, let's begin real cases now. This case has breast cancer. Many years ago, she got chemo and radiation therapy. Her mother has breast cancer. September 2022, this is the routine follow-up exam. What do you think? Everybody can open the case? Okay, I hope so. Do you have any suspicious area? Okay, this is the result of the transpara. In the operational area, there is suspicious, highly suspicious areas marked by the transpara. When we enlarge the image, as all you are breast radiologists, you couldn't find anything important. There is a structural distortion in the operational area. And as you know, AI systems are not trained for operated breast. There is always false positives in the operational area. You don't follow this kind of markings well. Okay, this is another case. Lady has a breast cancer on the right hand side nearly 7 years ago. This is the September 2020 routine follow-up exam. This I was in, you know, I work in private setting. This is the last patient of the Saturday, last patient of the week. Can you open the case, mammograms? My technicians usually copy-paste the patient's old report into current one, and I finalize the report with small minor changes, and they copy their this lady's report. I couldn't notice anything and keep going. And this is the transpara case number two, high, very high score. And I suppose the right-hand side is a little bit smaller and there is a little bit structural distortion. Oh, I suppose it's a false positive again. But normally our technicians pop up the AI results at the back of the ultrasound exam. This time, the last patient of the week, nobody cares. Everybody wants to go home. And I suddenly pop up the transpara results on the left-hand side. Do you notice anything? Yes, there is a small group of micro calcifications. And actually, I missed this case because of the hurry of the day. And you can also see the Lunit images in your workstations if you want to see. And this is the transpara score. September 2021 was 5, and current exam was transpara score is 10. And I organize a vacuum biopsy Monday morning 7:30. This is the results. High grade DCIS. As you know, AI system are not operated for operated breast, but women have opposite breast. AI system are better than radiologists at detecting microcalcifications, usually, as you know. Okay, this is the case number three. Everybody can open the case. Okay, it's not sequential in your workstations. Please be careful. September 2021, transpara score was 4. September 2022, routine screening mammograms. This is the case. Do you notice anything? Structural distortion could be. Also, this is the results of LUNIT. And this is the result of Transpara on the MLO low suspicious area in the intermediate risk area. That's why we make TOMO. This is the TOMO evaluation of the LUNIT. Slice 30, it has a finding, score is quite high. This is the magnified view of the, maybe you can see it. And vacuum biopsy revealed radial scar. In your workstation, you can see the also breast MRI of the cases. As we know from our daily practice, tomosynthesis is more successful than normal mammography, 2D mammography in detecting spicular lesions. AI system that can evaluate tomosynthesis are very important. It's helped our practice and sometimes reduce the evaluation time. Okay, case number 4. Everybody can open it. Ece, you can do that. Okay, 2022 normal mammograms was normal. 2022 routine mammograms. Do you notice anything? 2D mammograms. Is there anybody have any idea which breast is the suspicious? Okay. Left hand side is the normal 2D mammogram evaluation of the Transpara. This is the TOMA evaluation of the mammogram. This is the slice number 12, has a problem, and this is the suspicious area. 2D mammogram doesn't show anything, but on TOMO stuck, you if you want, you can go to slice number 12. Ece, can you do that? Is it possible? And this is the magnified view of the TOMO slice number 12. There is a spicular lesion. And Transpara takes our attention to that area. This is the sonography and biopsy luminal B breast cancer. My technicians always says AI system are part of our team and are like our third or fourth eyes in our daily routine. Okay, case number 5. This lady has a lot of fibrillar adenomas in the sonography and mammography exam, past exams. And January 2024, this is her screening mammograms. Is there anybody notice something on the mammograms? This is the type D breast, very dense breast. Do you notice anything? On the left-hand side, this my presentation screen. You can see the LUNIT results, and you can notice low suspicious area on the left upper part of the breast. This is the Transpara results. This is the normal 2D mammography. This is the 3D mammography evaluation, and score is going up, as you know, from 83 to 91, because speculation is we see better on the tomosynthesis better than mammography. Also, same is available for the AI systems. It gives higher score for the speculations. This is the case. TOMO slice, and this is the magnified view of the TOMO. There is a very spicular lesion in the middle of three fibroadenomas. that can be easily overlooked and is easily detected with the help of AI. As you know, there is a lot of round densities, and one of them has specular margins and is highlighted by AI, and it's directed our attention to that area. This is the ladies' sonographies. If you want, you can see in your workstation. There is a lot of fibroadenomas. One of them is very well, very speculated, and we make the biopsy of it. It was luminal A breast cancer. This is the MRI of this lady. And post-op pathology, it was a luminal A breast cancer. One of the sentinel node was metastatic. Okay. Is there anybody have any question till now? Okay. We can keep going now. Case number 6. Lady is in menopause. She's taking hormone replacement therapy. This is this screening exam 2022. Do you notice anything? Okay. Also, as you see from the left-hand side of your screen, transparent show high marks, and there is a little bit suspicious area. In this situation, we always use, as you do, we compare previous one and current ones. When we compare this lady's current ones and previous ones, we couldn't notice any difference. And we, of course, we directed our ultrasound this area, but we couldn't find anything, and we reported as normal. As you know, stability is the most reliable sign of benignity. In your workstation, you can see 4-year sequence of this lady. There is nothing change. But AI system does not compare current one and previous one. In that small summation areas, they have this kind of intermediate or high risk score in the summation of the score. This is the 1 year lady later. The same AI system shows nothing. And as you know, stability is the most reliable sign of the benignity. Okay, this case number 7, 2022 screening mammograms. Please open the case. Did you find anything in the mammograms? Pardon? Hamartoma, right. It's a benign. What else? Do you notice anything else? We are looking for cancer, not hamartoma. Right breast. Okay. You can see right side of our screens. You can see transparent has marked a small macrocalcification area, quite highly suspicious. This is the result of the lunit. It's also suspicious for the microcalcifications. Where is this microcalcifications on the MLO view? Did you find them on the MLO view? I can show it for you. Yes, it was the dermal calcifications. But two AI system mark is the suspicious microcalcifications. Artificial intelligence system cannot analyze visual data from MLO and CC images in logical unity. We combine this data instantly when we make deduction. This is the dermal calcifications, but AI system does not do that. It's very easy for radiologists, but it's quite difficult for the AI systems. Okay, this is the patient's next year. What is the difference? Okay. Highly suspicious microcalcifications on the lunit evaluation. also Transpara evaluated the same case. Highly suspicious micro calcifications areas. But we know from the previous year it was the dermal. But this time it's not completely tangential. It's more difficult case for radiologists. It's on the on MLO, it's not on the dermal tangentially. Okay, this is the case number 8. Everybody, is it possible to open the case number 8? And 68 years old lady, her sister has breast and lung cancer, November 2023 screening mammograms. Do you notice anything on the screening mammograms? It just shows the current ones on the left side of me. Okay. Is there anything in the... Okay. And I will show the LUNIT results for you. It guides you to find the suspicious area. Yes, you are completely right. But this is the results of the Transpara. It also highlights the same area. It's very easy for radiologists. It's the this is the vascular calcifications, but both MRI system, well-known FDA-approved AI system, vascular calcification, which can be easily recognized by radiologists, are sometimes flagged with high suspicions area by AI systems. It is our main job as a radiologist to prevent such simple mistakes that can AI make during daily routine. Okay. Case number 9, March 2023, mammograms was normal for this lady. June 2023, she has started hormone replacement therapy. And January 2024, 10 months later after the mammograms, she felt a mass in her left breast. And she came for diagnostic evaluation before her yearly mammogram doesn't arrive. Okay, do you notice anything? January 2024 current one, 2020 previous one. Okay. This is the current one. Do you notice anything? I will help you with the results of AI systems. This is the LUNIT result. You can see on my right side. This is the previous mammograms evaluated by LUNIT normal. This is the current one evaluated by LUNIT. There is a suspicious area on the left-hand side. Also, this is the Transpara results. Transpara evaluated as tomo also normal. This side is the tomo, this side is the 2D, and it was completely normal. But this year, 10 months later, the lady has flagged with highly suspicious areas. There are many publications showing that AI reduced interval cancer, including one of our study in Turkey. But of course, AI cannot detect all interval cancers. And a screening with zero interval cancer is not possible, as you know. But in 10 months, we all three missed this cancer. I missed this cancer 10 months ago. Two AI systems missed it. But during this period, she takes hormone replacement therapy. Okay, this is the image of ultrasound and MRI of this lady with luminal B meme breast carcinoma. Okay, case number 10. 45-year-old lady, routine screening mammograms. Do you notice anything? Okay. This is the result of the Transpara in MLO views. It's marked by Transpara highly suspicious region. In this situation, what do you do? You can you look at the tomo? It's available for you in your workstation. Do you notice anything on the tomo? Okay, this is the tomo evaluation of the Transpara. In 2D mammography, there is Transpara highlighted as suspicious area, but on the tomo, there is nothing important. As in all radiology practice, if the image seen one projection and does not have counterpart in the orthogonal image, you should approach it with suspicions, first of all. Secondly, if there is a suspicion in the mammography and this suspicion is not present in the tomo image, is most likely summation. And some summation is highlighted with AI system as a suspicious areas, but we solved this problem in our daily routine with tomo. Also AI highlighted you with tomo evaluation. Okay, this is case number 11. A foreign lady came to our hospital with a diagnosis of left breast cancer. Lump is palpable. And our oncologist ordered mammography and sonography again to evaluate the pre-neoadjuvant chemotherapy situation. And she had nothing reported in their previous exams. What do you see in the mammos? What do you see in the right place? Marco, you are completely right. And this is the evaluation of the Transpara. She has huge mass, axillary positive breast cancer. It's a candidate for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, but on the right side, there is suspicious microcalcifications. Yes, you are right. This is also Lunit results. And one of our mistake as a radiologist, we frequently focus the more obvious lesions, and computer programs have the advantages of having no emotions. They always do their work carefully in the same routine, but we sometimes focus on the obvious lesion and miss the less obvious lesion. This is the right-hand side small carcinoma. This is the reason the lady came in. Okay, case number 12. Lady has no birth. She had a lot of IVF attempts. Her sister has breast carcinoma and she felt lump in the right breast. This is the case, Lunit evaluation. She felt lump in her right breast. Okay. Do you notice anything? Behind the nipple. Okay. Also, this is the results of Lunit. There is nothing important. It guides you, it says there is nothing. Maybe she felt nothing. Okay. This is the results of the Transpara. There is nothing important. Low result is low risk. But when you look at the image closely, especially MLO, is there any asymmetry over there in the inferior part of the breast? Also, you can notice the skin thickening. Do you notice it when you compare right and left side? Also, a little bit architectural distortion and asymmetric density over there. Perhaps AI system are trained mostly on the screening patients. They do not recognize indirect signs of breast cancer that are readily apparent to the radiologist. We sometimes focus on because of the skin thickening and we focus on the asymmetry a lot, but they do not. This is the MRI of the patient. Huge mass. Cut biopsy was luminal B breast cancer. This is the skin thickening of MLO. And this is the sonography of the mass. This mass, this size mass flagged normal with two AI systems. This is the pathology. Okay. Case number 13. December 2023 screening mammograms. Please closely look at these screening mammograms. Do you notice anything? Is there any suspicious area for you? Okay, sir.
Asymmetries.
Is it important for you?
Yeah.
It dictates something. What's your next?
DBT.
And this is the evaluation of the lunito is also normal. This is the evaluation of the tomo is also intermediate and maybe low score. And you can look at the closely CC view. There is a big difference on the CC view, important asymmetry. We look at ultrasound. We perform ultrasound small hypoechoic areas. We perform the biopsy. It was invasive carcinoma. And two AI systems says it's normal. AI system are not good enough in at comparing the current and prior mammograms and are not good enough comparing the right and left breast. Okay. This is the easier case. Can you open case 14? Lady has no family history. January 2024 screening mammograms. Do you notice anything on the mammograms?
Nipple retraction.
Everybody says instant the nipple retraction. Is it important for the AI system? No. This is the result of the unit. It isn't highlighted. This is the result of the transpara. There is no highly suspicious area. This is the MRI of this lady. This is the sonography of this lady. Because of this nipple retraction, it's directed our attention to that area. We make perform the ultrasound. And pathology was luminal B breast carcinoma. In the last three examples, I have shown that indirect sign of breast cancer, such as asymmetric density, skin thickening and nipple retraction can be missed by AI. It's our job to catch this kind of changes. While AI evaluate mammogram as a patchwork, as a radiologist, we make the first evaluation by looking at the whole picture. But AI system look at the mammograms as a patchwork. They don't see the whole picture. And since our artificial intelligence system make evaluation at pixels level, each time is better than radiologists in detail, such as small microcalcifications, such as small speculated lesions. But when you compare the right and left side as a whole picture or prior and current one, they are not good enough. You have to know it. And be careful about this subject. Okay. This is the case 15. Can you open it? This is the screening mammography. No family history. Okay. Do you notice something?
On the left side.
Yes. Small dot. Maybe small cancer. This is the magnified view on the right-hand side of my screen. Okay, this is the evaluation of the transpara. It's highlighted small dot, highly suspicious. It's also lunit highlighted this small lesion. And 1 year ago, unit score was low. Transparency score is also low. And during this 1 year, lesion get a little bit bigger. And in the size of 3 or 4 millimeter, AI system guided us to suspicious area. We make the ultrasound, find the lesion, and it was luminal A breast cancer. AI is very helpful in detecting very small spicular lesions that can be easily overlooked by radiologists in some times. Okay, this is case number 16. She has excisional breast biopsy 20 years ago. Pathology was ductal intraepithelial neoplasia 1A, papillomatosis, sclerosis anastomosis 20 years ago. And this is the mammogram of this lady. Do you have any suspicious area in the mammograms? Left side, left breast, which breast? Okay, she has a lot of microcalcification, distributed microcalcification structure, dense breast, not easy to evaluate, yes. And this is the result of AI system, two AI systems side by side. Lunit highlighted left breast, transpara highlighted right breast. What will you do? Like us radiologists, AI system does not always agree on the same case. Like we do, we don't agree on the same case sometimes. One of them says suspicious area on the left-hand side, other one says suspicious areas on the right-hand side. In this situation, we always go to previous exams. We compare the previous one and current one. If everything was stable, we report normal report, but they don't compare current one and prior one. Okay, this is the same case. Lunit 2020 evaluate as a left-hand side is problematic. 3 years ago, it shows right-hand side is problematic. It's like us radiologists, AI system also suffer from intra-observer variability. It's not they are not always consistent. In this workshop, I aim to provide you some example that will help you when you use decision support system in your daily routine. As a lady, how would your mammograms would be evaluated? What's your preference? Two radiologists evaluate your mammograms. One radiologist and one CAT system do you prefer? Or two CAT system wants to evaluate your mammograms? Which is your preference? Huh? Yes, of course. But there is a lot of retrospective and prospective trials like Masai and screen trials. Radiologist CAD arm usually catch a little bit more cancer than the two radiologist arm because radiologist and AI collaboration is the winning combination because we have some weakness and strengths. Also, AI system has different weakness and strengths because of the structure of the systems. Okay. As you know, AI makes some predictions on the system. As a radiologist, we make judgment, we written down the report, and we manage the patient. They don't manage the patient. And I believe AI is a great aid for the breast radiologist in diagnostic and screening setting, and collaboration with AI is very helpful in our daily routine. I use them for 6 years. I am very happy with this collaboration. And okay, you can go backward and see the cases if you want. This is the number of the cases and brief description of the cases. Okay, do you have any questions? This is my, please go ahead. Second reader, not the first reader. During my daily routine, I briefly tried to explain it. We make the mammography. Our technician prepared the lady ultrasound. During that time, two AI system evaluate the mammography before my ultrasound exam. We can see the results of two AI just begin at the beginning of the ultrasound exam. And also in the same room, we can see the previous mammograms, previous ultrasound, previous reports. Quite easier for me to evaluate the ladies with AI, with the help of AI. Yes. So I first see the mammography, then look at the AI system. But usually my technician open the AI result if there is something on the system. Otherwise, they open the only mammograms. If there is something on the AI system, it's highlighted. And she puts the AI results at the back of the back screen of the ultrasound table. We are in private practice. 90% of the patients we do perform ultrasound.
And do you do it or technician does?
Yeah, I do it myself. Please go. Of course, you are biased. But you have to realize you are the responsible of the cases. Of course, you have to compare current and prior ones and ultrasonography exam. Also, patient history always in front of me. And but it's also guide me. You have to put some limit the influence of the AI in your routine. You have to put some limits. There is a lot of cases. There is negative AI. I make the biopsy, find the cancer, of course. Keep going. I don't understand you. Yeah, I feed it Transpara. We give them labeled data, but not daily. They are not daily cases. We pull the cases. This is the normal. This is the cancer cases, and we labeled the data to feed the Transpara, and they organize. But training of the system is completely different situation. They don't train on the daily routine cases. Yes, of course. We have collaboration agreement with the Transpara. That's why we give them. No, the AI system does. It's impossible for them to compare previous and current ones. We do that. It's our responsibility. Now, as I show you in an animation, they look at the picture as a patchwork. They don't see the image as a whole. They look at the image small patches because of the hardware and software requirements. Is there any other questions? Thank you for joining the Fuji workshop. I hope you enjoy.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks.